Evaporators in residential HVAC systems have refrigerant flowing through them. As air is blown over the evaporator coils, it gets heated or cooled. In the chiller systems, the evaporator coils filled with refrigerant have water flowing over them instead of air. This is how the refrigerant cools the water. A shell and tube evaporator has two parts, an outer shell, and inner tubes. The outer shell is a large metallic cylinder. The shell performs two main functions, protecting the inner tubes, and not allowing the fluid in the shell to leak outside. It has two openings, an inlet and an outlet for the fluid to flow into and out of the shell. The inner copper tubes enter the outer shell from one side, and leave through the other side. Keep in mind that copper is an excellent conductor of heat. Copper tubes allow the transfer of heat from the fluid inside to the fluid outside the tube. Water flows inside these tubes, while the outer shell is filled with refrigerant. The two fluids do not mix with each other, and only heat transfers take place between the fluids. In some chillers, the refrigerant may flow through the inner tubes, and water may be used in the outer shell. We see the following types of compressors and chillers: scroll compressors, screw compressors, and centrifugal compressors. We mainly use two types of condensers and chiller systems: fin and tube condenser, and shell and tube condenser. The two types of metering devices used in chillers are thermal expansion valves and electronic expansion valves. Chiller systems usually contain shell and tube evaporators. A shell and tube evaporator is the most efficient type of evaporator to transfer heat between two liquids.